I think we'll call this one Battle of the Battle Rifles. Why not? Springfield's M1A, which is the civilian version of the M14. And then, of course, Stoner's AR-10, this one being a Smith & Wesson M&P10. So I figured I would just use probably the most common ammunition that one of these two rifles might use, and that's the M80 ball round. It's a 149 grain full metal jacket, NATO's ball round, right? So the actual ammo that I'm using is a Winchester white box version of that. So I just want to see how each one of these rifles shoot it. We'll start at 100 yards and see how they do there. We'll just do grouping. We won't worry too much about hitting the little orange dot or anything like that. We're just going to do some grouping exercises. And time and battery power, probably battery power being the most limiting factor. But if we have time and battery power, we'll stretch it on out to, you know, 300 or 500 yards. We'll see. We'll just see how we do. So anyway, let's get started with this M1A. And I will shoot at the top dot. Second shot was me. I'm gonna fire one more. Wouldn't think I would miss that bad. 100 yards. Okay, that's better. Well, I hate to think that I would yanked it off that bad. That's my little makeshift cheek riser. Just a rag wraps with some electrical tape. I've got one on order, but it hasn't shown up yet, so I just, improvise. Adapt and overcome, right? So, let's move on and see how this M&P10 compares. Accuracy-wise at 100 yards with this M80 ball round. This one doesn't shoot this ammo very good either. Just to be fair, I'm going to fire one more shot like I did with the M1A. Wow. Neither one of them real impressive. At 100 yards. Now, this, keep in mind, this is just one type of ammunition through two types of rifles. At this point, I'm a little disappointed with probably the ammunition. I know both these rifles will shoot better than this. So, it's the only ammunition I brought with me today. Not real impressed, but let's go ahead, while we got time and battery power, let's go ahead and set up a couple of targets out there. It's I will just go to 300 and see how we can do at 300 yards. So sit tight. All right, so I've got two steel targets set up out there at 300 yards, and once again, I'm just gonna go for grouping. I've not going to try and dial it in to this ammunition right now. I just want to see how well it'll group at 300 versus 100. So far at 100, I'm not very impressed with either rifle. That is to say, could be the ammunition. But like I said, I didn't bring any other ammunition. So 300 yards, I got two steel targets set up out there. We'll shoot at the left target with the M1A and the right target with the AR-10, the Smith & Wesson. And as you can see, I've got them offset just a little bit. That's just in case there's any spall, knock paint off the target or anything like that. So that's all that's for. So, all right, let's get started. Okay, pretty low. I like that group at 300 a hell of a lot better than I do at 100. Looks like it's about a mil low at 300 yards with this zero, so no big deal. I like the group at 300 if it is what I'm seeing that it is. The four shots right there. About a minute of angle group at 300 yards. So let's move on to this AR-10. We'll see how we do with it. All right, so I come up about 1 mil on that scope. The reticle in this is a Leupold Mark IV. The reticle is in mils, but the adjustments are in minutes, so it takes just a little bit of math. So 1 mil at 300 yards is about 10.2 inches or something like that. So that's what I'll come up here. So 3, 6, 9. Yeah, we'll go just a little bit higher. Come up about 11 inches with this. All right, firing at the right target. Just a little bit right. We'll go about a minute left. That last one's barely on the target. Well, let's go up and do a little target review at 300 yards. We'll do a 100-yard target review and then a 300 target review. So, give me just a couple minutes. Well, here's the 300-yard group with the M1A, with the M80 ball round. And left to right, it's about 3 1/4 inches, so just outside minute of angle. Up and down, obviously, up and down less than a minute of angle, but the entire group is just outside minute of angle, we'll call it. So that's pretty darn good at 300 yards. And obviously it's about a mil low. So about 11 inches low. So just outside of a mil low. But we wasn't shooting for to hit the red dot. We were just grouping, right? So not a big deal. I know that if I'm going to use that ammunition, I have to come up another mil above and beyond what I did. So anyway, the M&P10 group. Not even really what I would call a group, so. But I know from past experience of having that rifle, it's very finicky. It likes only certain types of ammunition, and it shoots the best with reloads. But I don't really like reloading for a semi-auto. We all know why, right? But yeah, the clear winner today, the M1A with the mass-produced M80 ball round. Clear winner, 300 yards. Let's go take a look at the 100-yard group, and we'll compare those. We'll put the tape measure to them and see what we think. Okay, so the four shots with the M&P10. Gosh, it's probably, wow. 6 inches left to right, terrible. Now, with the M1A, it was shots like 1, 2, 3, and then 4. Now, I usually don't miss that bad at 100 yards. Was it me? Was it a bad round? I don't know, but the four shot came back and cut the second shot. So I guess we take that as it is, but still the clear winner. If you look at just these three versus like these three, it's still way better. Yeah. Anyway, guess it is what it is. You know, one type of ammunition is what it is. For me today, with this ammunition, the clear winner is the M1A, the Springfield M1A. So. Anyway, think what you think, I guess. I don't know. Which one would I stake my life on? Probably with that ammunition. Obviously the M1A. So, anyway, have a great day.